What up, YouTube? It's your boy, Anime Specialist. So ever since the Water Temple arc, I've done a review after each arc to say what I thought about the specific arc. And now that the Warrior Knight Selection Tournament has ended, I really wanted to talk about the tournament, but more specifically, who I think is going to become a Warrior Knight for the next arc to fight the Eye of the Midnight Sun. So let's get right to it, man. So my theories about who's going to become a Royal Knight is going to be based upon what happened in the latest tournament and what we've seen lately, especially the new key visuals. So in the new key visuals, we can see that Luck, Asta, Yuno, Zora and Lady Leona are going to be Royal Knights because they have different robes that looks like it's going to be what the Royal Knights are going to have. Yes, on the new key visuals, we can see that Yami and the Magic King are on it, but I don't think they're going to be Royal Knights. Obviously, the Magic King is the Magic King, but I don't think Yami is going to become one of the Royal Knights because I think he's going to have a different arc for this new arc in general, you know, so he's going to have a different mission or something like that. So that's my opinion right there. And then in the opening, we saw other members, I think, of the Royal Knights. We can see Ryl. Obviously, he was in the finals. We can see Mimosa. We can see Noel. We can see Nozel Silva, Noel's brother. And we also see, like we saw in the key visuals, Lady Leona. So I think that those members in the opening right there are all going to become Royal Knights. So far we can see that there's going to be at least three Magic Knight captains in the Royal Knights. Like I said, Nozel Silva, Lady Leona, and Ryl, the captain of the Aqua Deer. We all know how strong they are. We haven't seen Nozel Silva and Lady Leona go full power yet, but we know that they're really strong. They're both members of the two most powerful families in the Clover Kingdom, in my opinion, you know, the Vermilion and the Silvers. Except from what we've seen so far in the opening and the new key visuals, the reason why I think Zora and Mimosa are going to become Royal Knight is because they've gone far in the tournament and they're really strong, they're really important. You know, we know how important Zora was in the tournament and how he uses his magic circle, and Mimosa is really important because she can heal. She's the only character that we know so far, I think, that can heal, so she's gonna be really important. So that's why I think they're gonna become Royal Knights. Also, the reason why I think Noelle is gonna become a Royal Knight is because the Magic King saw how strong she is, and I think he knows how strong she can become, and she was one of the strongest and most powerful mages, Magic Knight in the tournament, you know, so she proved herself once again, and she won the tournament, you know. She was on the same team that Yuno was, so she deserves to be a Royal Knight. Obviously, Yuno is going to become one of the Royal Knight because he was one of the strongest Magic Knight in the tournament. He was going easy on his opponent the whole tournament, except for the final fight against Ryl, Magic Knight captain of the Aqua Deer, and for me he was the strongest or the second to third strongest in the tournament. There's Ryl, then there's Yuno, and then there's Asta. So they were the three strongest Magic Knight in the tournament, in my opinion. So that's a pretty easy prediction. Same thing for Asta. He was one of the strongest in the Royal Knight tournament. And like I said, I think that Asta was one of the top three strongest with Ryl and Yuno. So that's another pretty easy prediction, in my opinion. He's the main character. He has a demon form, one of the strongest form that we've seen so far in the show. So I'm hyped to see Asta in action with the strongest of the strongest. Julius the Magic King said that he was going to choose between 10 and 20 Magic Knights to become Royal Knights, but I think he's going to choose between 10 and 15. So I made a list of who I think is going to become one of the Royal Knights. Obviously, the names that are there I've talked about during the video, but this list is up to debate and discussion. It's not a definitive list. There can be more names or less names. I don't know right now. So the names that I have are Lady Leona, the captain of the Crimson Lions. The second one is Nozel Silva, the captain of the Silver Eagles. The third one is Real, the captain of the Aqua Deer. The fourth one is Scourge Vermilion, Mimosa's brother. I've actually forgot to talk about him during the video, so my bad about that. After that, there's Asta, Yuno, and Locke from the Black Bulls. Then there's Zora, and Zora is kind of interesting because we don't know on which team he is. Maybe he's gonna join the Purple Orcas like his father, or maybe he's gonna join the Black Bull, so that's gonna be interesting. And then there's obviously Mimosa, so those are the names right now that I think for sure are gonna become Royal Knights. So let me know in the comments down below who you think is gonna become a Royal Knight and who you think maybe on the list is not. Anyway, man, maybe I've forgotten some characters to put on the list, so my bad about that, but I didn't put the characters that I think are father characters that was on some teams and didn't do enough. So I just put the really important characters in my opinion. But yeah, man, I'm hyped for next week's episode. I'm hyped for the next arc. Thank you for Kitaru Kun. He said that next week's episode is part of a light novel, so thanks for that. But yeah, man, I'll see you in the next video. I do a lot of anime content like Black Clover reviews, One Piece reviews, Kimetsu no Yaiba reviews, and Attack on Titan reviews, so subscribe for that. Follow me at Anime Specialist on Twitter and Instagram. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Anime Specialist out. Peace.